students. Good morning to all. Today we have starting our second unit point Excel. Okay, so we have starting Excel. First of all, the definition of Excel. An Excel is a central shaft for a rotating wheel or gear. Or a different definition, a bar that connects a pair of wheels on a vehicle. Okay. On wheeled vehicles, the axle may be fixed to the wheels, rotating with them, or fixed to the vehicle, with the wheels rotating around the axle. So, bearings or bushing are provided at the mounting points where the axle is supported. Okay. Then, types of axle. So, in these types of axle, there are mainly three types: front axle, rear axle, and stub axles. So, types of axle, we have to see that a rear axle. Subtypes are full floating axle, semi floating axle, three quarter axle. Then, in the front axle, subtypes are dead front axle, line front axle. Then, stub axle, Elliott axle, reversed axle, Lemoine axle, reverse Lemoine axle. These are the types of axles. Okay. Then first we are taking as a rear axle. Rear axle, in between the differential and the driving wheel is the rear axle to transmit the power from the differential to the driving wheels. It is clear from the construction of the differential that the rear axle is not a single piece, but it is in two halves connected by the differential. One part is known as the half shaft. The inner end of the half shaft is connected to the differential, and the outer part, the outer end of the shaft is connected to the driving wheels. Okay. Then in rear axle, there are three types of rear axle: semi floating axle, fully floating axle, and three quarter axle. So one by one we are taking as semi floating axle. Okay. So in semi floating axle, you have to see that a diagram, simple axle shaft. Okay. Then axle casing, then in between axle casing and shaft, the bearing are mounted, right? Then wheel hub connected to the axle shaft. Okay. So this type of axle is a semi floating axle. A semi floating axle has a bearing located on the axle and inside the axle casing, right? We have to see that in diagram. There is a bearing is in between a axle shaft and axle casing. It has us to support all the loads. This bearing are for the support all the loads. Therefore, it needs to be of a larger size for the same torque output than other type. The inner end of the axle is supported by the differential side gears, right? So it is thus relieved of the job of carrying the weight of the housing. Okay. The outer end has to stop the weight of the car and take end thrust. The inner end of the axle is pliant to the differential gear. Okay. The outer end is flanged so that wheel can be bolted directly to it. Okay, in some design, the hub of the wheel is key to the outer end of the axle. The vehicle load is transmitted to the axle through the casing and the bearing, which causes the bending or shearing of the axle. The semi-floating axle is the simplest and the cheapest of all types of widely used on cars, right? So these are the simple semi-floating axle. Okay. Simple diagram, we have to see that पिक्चर तुम्हाला दिसत आहे. ओके, दिस इज अ सेम पिक्चर, राईट. दिस इज अ हब, राईट. दिस इज अ व्हील हब. ओके, देन दॅट इज अ शाफ्ट. ओके, दॅट एक्सेल केसिंग. ओके, इन बिटवीन द एक्सेल केसिंग अँड सिम्पल द बेरिंग्स आर माउंटेड, राईट. ओके, यू हॅव टू सी दिस इन डायग्राम. ओके, देन सेकंड इज फुल्ली फ्लोटिंग ऑर अ फुल फ्लोटिंग एक्सेल. ओके, इन दिस फुल फ्लोटिंग एक्सेल वी हॅव टू सी दॅट इन दिस डायग्राम. ओके, द बेरिंग, राईट, द बेरिंग इज अपवर्ड ऑफ द एक्सेल केसिंग, राईट, ऑर इन बिटवीन द एक्सेल केसिंग अँड व्हील हब. ओके, अ फुल्ली फ्लोटिंग एक्सेल हॅज टू डीप ग्रूव बॉल ऑर टेपर रोलर बेरिंग, राईट. इन दिस टाईप ऑफ फुल फ्लोटिंग एक्सेल हॅज टू डीप ग्रूव बॉल बेरिंग्स ऑर अ टेपर रोलर बेरिंग्स आर लोकेटेड इन द एक्सेल केसिंग अँड द व्हील हब. यू हॅव टू सी दॅट इन दिस डायग्राम. सॉरी, you have to see that, see that. We have to see that in this diagram, right. The bearing is in between the axle casing and the wheel hub. Okay, so the outer of an axle is made flange to which the wheel hub is bolted, right. The wheel hub is bolted. Okay, you have to see in this diagram, the wheel hub is bolted. Okay, then the axle is not supported by bearing at either ends, right. The in axle, right, the bearing is not supported at the other end. Okay, so and its position is maintained by the way that is supported at the ends. Thus, the axle is relieved of all strain caused by the vehicle on the end thrust. It transmits only driving torque, right? For this reason, it is called fully floating, right? The axle may be removed from the housing without disturbing the wheel by removing the nuts, right? In this, there are a bolt in a hub, the bolts are removing, then the total axle are will be removing from the axle casing. Okay, an additional advantage of this design is the ability of the vehicle, even if it has broken axle. This type of axle is more expensive and heavier than other axle. It is usually fitted on commercial vehicle. Then this is a simple diagram of full floating axle, right. We have to see that in this diagram, right. The bearing, right, the bearing is between the axle shaft and the wheel hub, right. This is the bearing. Okay, these are the picture of full floating axle. With the help of this nut bolts, right, you have to remove the all shaft. Then third type of three quarter floating axle, you have to see that in this diagram. The simple the wheel bearing or bearing are in between the axle casing and the wheel hub. This type of axle has bearing placed between the hub and the axle casing. Thus the weight of vehicle is transferred to the axle casing and only the side thrust and driving torque are taken by the axle, right. Only the side thrust and driving torque are taken by the axle and other will be transferred to the axle casing. Okay, the axle is keyed rigidly to the hub, right. Jo axle ahe to tumcha hub la with the help of keyed ha rigidly lock kelela ahe kiwa keyed kela ahe. Thus providing the driving connection and maintaining the alignment of the wheel, the inner end of the axle has the same construction as that of the semi-floating axle. Although the three-quarter floating axle is more reliable, it is not as simple as semi-floating axle. Okay, so these are the simple types of